The largest model that can be built with the tensegrity toolkit is the dodecahedron. The dodecahedron has 12 pentagonal faces and 20 corners in which three edges converge. We start, like always, building the first edge in a way that the knots of the sticks that we connect point towards the short end of the string where we connect it in. Five of those corners will surround each base, so we continue by building this very first face of our dodecahedron in a way that in each string there is one stick that connects from the right and one from the left, and each newly connected stick has the knot pointing towards the short end of the string. And a bit similar to the way we built the cube, is that as soon as we have four corners together, parts of the first and the fourth corner built, already the fifth one. So now we can take any of those nearly completed sides and complete them. This is three corners. Four corners for the next one. This one, which is already the third corner of the neighboring pentagonal side. It doesn't really matter in which direction you continue, but it's a good idea to proceed systematically. Which helps you bring the model into a shape where it pretty much helps by warping into the closer to the final shape. Now already you can see how the model gets more and more into a three-dimensional object. You might want to turn it around at this stage, but you don't really need to as yet. And it's quite fun to notice how stable this halfway built object already is. So 1, 2, 3, 4, which means this will be corner number 5. And potentially the right time to turn the model around. We simply continue with what we've done so far. Completing more and more triangular corners and while taking care that we don't have more than 5 corners to each and every see whether we can already complete another corner or face with it. And although I'm not too sure why the last steps went so easy, there is the largest structure, largest symmetrical structure you can build with the tensegrity toolkit, which is the dodecahedron. You can see the pentagonal faces quite easily. And depending on the size of your corner triangles, the structure made easily or less easily balanced on one of the corners has this little bounce in it. And another thing to notice about this model, it has been built out of the same toolkit that has been used for all the instructional videos, which means it's definitely reusable, and detaching the toolkit is even faster than building with it. So once you finish your project and you want to go on to the next one, it's a simple process to disassemble your finished projects and have your toolkit ready for the next exploration of tensegrity structures. The rubber will stretch a little bit when you start playing with your toolkit, but the tolerances are chosen in a way that even with a bit more stretch on your original tendons, the models will have a good fit and a nice bounce to them.